We're going to look at how final grade submission works. We'll start in the Canvas gradebook. Grade your assignments as you ordinarily would. It isn't necessary to change all of the dashes to zeros, although that is a best practice that we do recommend. Once you are satisfied with the grades in your gradebook, click on the final grade submission here in the course navigation menu. Now that we're in the final grade submission tool, you will notice the following columns: student name, score with blanks ignored, score with blanks treated as zero, current letter grade, official grade, F reason, and last attended date. The score with the blanks ignored column is showing us what the student's score is, ignoring any missing grades in the gradebook. The score with blanks treated as zero column is treating all blanks as zeros. If you are using a grading scheme in your course, the current letter grade will appear here. The official grade is the one which will be sent to PeopleSoft. It is already populated with the grades in the score blanks treated as zero column. This column is editable. If I want to give a different grade than is listed here, I simply need to type it in. This will accept letter grades with pluses and minuses and numerical grades. It will also accept an I for incomplete and an X, which you will only want to use if there should happen to be a student appear on this list who for some reason is not in your course roster. The X will not give them a grade. PeopleSoft will ignore the grade for the student in this class. So now I'll begin my final grade submission. Annie Alpha didn't do well in my class, but she earned her F and was in attendance throughout the end of the course. So for the reason, I'm going to select attended. Barry Bravo also has failed, but he quit coming to class. For the F reason, I will select non-attendance. In the date picker, I will select the date in which he last attended class. Carrie Charlie never attended class, so I will select that as my F reason. Davy Delta has made an arrangement for an incomplete. I'm going to type in an I for the incomplete on the official grade column. There's a small chance that a student who belonged to this course previously but has dropped will show up in the final grade submission tool. If this is the case, you can type an X as the grade and PeopleSoft will ignore that student. So I'm going to type an X in here. Frankie Foxtrot did a great job in my class. In fact, he's so close to a 93 that I'm going to give it to him. I will type the 93 in this score and it will be overridden. If necessary, I can save my entered grades and come back. However, in this case, I'm going to click on Submit Final Grades. From here, we're warned that this is the only submission we will be able to do from Canvas. After this, the Final Grade Submission tool will be locked. The only way to edit grades at that point would be to do it inside of PeopleSoft. I'm going to click here, and my submission to PeopleSoft is complete. For this semester, using this tool, we would ask you, please go to PeopleSoft and verify grade submission. Please notify the help desk if there are any discrepancies. If you require assistance, please contact a Falcon Online Instructional Designer. Falcon's up!